Welcome to Oklahoma Baptist University School of Music. We're so excited to have you here. We're going to have a great semester planned for you.
Nutrition is very important. It involves what goes inside of your body. Look, I understand Chick-fil-A.
Tonic.
Predominant, dominant.
Tonic. Here we are at the predominant. We are about to move to the dominant. And then back to the tonic.
So this chopping guy, why did he use all these double sharps?
Are we really gonna let him get away with this?
So I got this sweater from my mom for a Christmas present. So I got this one from my best friend's dad in the seventh grade. So I got this one November 2nd, 1991 from my professor's second wife. So I got this one from my uncle's pastor's son. Yeah, this one's from Walmart.
How do you make a Kleenex dance? Put a little boogie in it. Why did the Clydesdale give the pony a glass of water? Because he was a little horse. What is Harry Potter's favorite way to get down a hill? Walking. JK, Rowling.
Well, you need to leave then.
We were told that we could practice in here.
You need to leave.
So, this is binary form. So what time is it, son?
We have about 2 minutes.
Oh, plenty of time! Sonata 4!
Dr. Chung!
Oh, hi, Emily.
Are you allowed to be in here?
Yeah, I have it reserved.
Can I see your ID? Get out.
Everybody says don't, everybody says don't, everybody. I'm sorry, Dr. Lee, what were my first words again? Everybody says don't. Everybody says don't, it isn't right!
Rachel, singing a perfect 15th. I just played it.
Okay, chorale. All right, let's turn to rehearsal D, Dagwood. And now to my favorite composer, Bach. All right, now remember, this is gonna be pert near memorized. Pert near. All right, we're showing up tomorrow at 6:41, looking fine. Women, you got your pearls on. Men, don't forget your bow tie.
Oh my goodness, Sid, I thought this was probably one of the best chorale concerts that we've done this
tour. Oh, little lady, I loved your offertory. Thank you for your playing. It was a great service.
Oh, thank you so much, but that's not me, that's Dr. Chung. She went that way.
I think this piece needs more angst.
Okay, so I see that where the exposition starts, and then the recapitulation. Is it ternary form?
No. Rhymes with bonata.
Sonata.
Ah, yes.
Once upon a time, make you listen. There's a
make time for relationships. The schoolwork and everything will always get done, but you should always make time for your friends. And also, don't do homework on Fridays because that's lame.
Love on your professors. Love them, pour into them. Make sure you make time to go visit them, to ask them about their day, because whenever you leave, you won't have that opportunity anymore. And it's just really important to love on them the way that they love on us.
When things aren't going your way, try to remember that it's not about you. Not to us, O Lord, not to us, but to your name give the glory.
Live in the moment and be thankful. Your life is going to change in so many ways. But your life doesn't belong to you. It belongs to the one who bought it with his blood. Seek him first and only. Also, stay away from Sydney Matthews.
You need to embrace everything that you have. Embrace every moment. Embrace every student, every faculty, every academy, because it is God's purpose in your life. There is a reason why that you are here at this very moment at OBU. And know that what you start here, as long as you let it grow, then it will be used by others later.
A lot of the time, everybody asks you, what do you do? And we tend to forget the why we do things. So whenever you are bogged down and everybody says, what do you do? And you're like, I'm a music major. Just remember why you are a music major. And that's because God has given you a song, and a song to sing or a song to play. And so just remember that and to do it for his glory.
I would just encourage everyone to dive in. Go full on into everything. Oral skills, theory, the harder stuff, the class stuff, even the more fun stuff. Go full on to friendships. And don't be half committed to anything. Go all in and do as good as you can. Do your best at everything you can.
Okay, so Dr. Lalit once wrote, I think it was on his one of his Facebook posts or something that are always very convicting. He wrote, I die to the death of a purposeless, distracted mind. I surrender to the life of living on purpose. And so my encouragement to you would be to live on purpose. Wherever you are, be all there. Whether you're sitting at lunch with a friend, or you're in a lesson, or you're in chapel, or you're in class, or you're in the lounge, or you're sitting writing a paper, be on purpose and be all there, because every moment that you have here, it only happens once, and God gives us each of those moments to teach us something or to shape us in some way, and if we check out, we don't give him that opportunity. So live on purpose.
Don't forget why you started music in the first place.
Just to spend time with the idea of loving well. Love the Father well every day, every moment that you can. It's so important to your walk here and your walk with God and for the rest of your life, really. Love others well. Love your classmates well, your professors well. They also bear the image of God, just like you do, and so they deserve that. Love yourself well, know your limits and your boundaries, but also be willing to take chances. Love your job well, your studies well, give them the effort and work that it requires to do that and to succeed. And last, I think this fits best for us, just love practicing well and the process well. It's not always about the performance and how it ends up, but really the time that you spend giving love to the art of singing or playing the trumpet or playing piano. Just know that God gave you the ability to create, and so pouring yourself into that creating, even in the practice room, is just as important as performing.